Korea's success in its own submarine-launched ballistic missile is raising tensions as heated responses come from within as well as outside the Korean Peninsula. North Korea revealed that Wednesday short-range ballistic missiles were fired from a train deep in the mountains and accurately hit its target 800 kilometers away. If true, analysts say the success would show the North's enhanced capability to target its missiles as well as move them away from danger, something that may prove to be essential. Just hours earlier, South Korea announced President Moon Jae-in attended the test of the country's first submarine-launched ballistic missile, making it the seventh country in the world to operate SLBMs. Talking to the crew of the submarine, Moon emphasized the test's importance.
그런 그 북한의 미대칭 전력에 대해서 우리 그 SLBM이 아주 효과적인 억제력이 될 수 있을 것이라고 생각합니다.
Seoul stressed the test had been pre-scheduled and was not a response to the North's weekend test of long-range cruise missiles. South Korea's test launch of the homegrown SLBM was from the 3,000-ton Dosan Anchang-ho submarine at a test site in the western city of Taiwan. The SLBM was one of a series of missiles that were unveiled on Wednesday. This included the quick supersonic cruise missile that are more likely to survive and hit its targets. The South's defense ministry said the missile is expected to be a core part of the nation's defense against anything that threatens its territorial waters. In addition, South Korea revealed it had developed a long-range air-to-land missile to be mounted on South Korea's supersonic fighter jets and a ballistic missile powerful enough to penetrate the North's underground bunkers. In response to President Moon's remarks, Kim Yo-jung, the powerful sister of North Korea's leader, warned of what she called complete destruction of inter-Korean relations. Japan's prime minister called the North Korean missile launch a threat to peace, while the U.S. State Department spokesman condemned Pyongyang's ballistic missile tests, which are in violation of U.N. Security Council resolutions. Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi, who was in Seoul for meetings at the time of the test, told reporters he hoped all countries, not just North Korea, would do things that would be helpful for peace and stability on the Korean Peninsula.